We've all looked to Israel with their vaccine rollout and everything. They sort of were ahead of us on everything. And they were the ones that were warning us months ago, get those boosters done, get them done, because we're finding that the efficacy of the first two jabs is waning. So get your boosters done. And the data is encouraging from Israel. So we know that boosters do work. Israel is proving that as the sort of forerunner. And we need to keep an eye on what Israel does next in terms of their vaccine rollout. But the data coming in, because they're ahead of us, is really, really good.
But, you know, there's almost more urgency for the youngsters to get vaccinated, isn't it? The 12 to 15 demographic, as opposed to the over 50s, because they haven't had their first vaccine.
Yeah.
And that's where the virus is transmitting the most at the moment. So all these, you were saying double page spreads in almost all of the papers.
Oh, in all of the papers.
The government's, you know, pushing.
Yeah.
But actually, are they kind of pushing it in perhaps the wrong direction?
I don't know. But there's, yeah, double page spread. All the newspapers are carrying it. Mm. It's clearly been paid for, in my view, by government. But it's all, it looks like an editorial, but it ain't. Mm. And it's just about how to prevent the spread of COVID in the winter months. But there's also some really interesting pieces. I think it's in The Observer, saying, you know, asking the question how the modellers have got it so wrong time and time again. You know, we were told that, you know, coming into after the Freedom Day, we'd have 100,000 cases a day. Mm. It's practically half that and going down. So in some areas. So the modellers, I think we've all lost patience with them. But there's some interesting stuff around about it.